Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Daiva V for the MSX. Now in the last part we gave the enemy a kind of a beating, although we did fail to capture one of the planets we were hoping to make our own. Fortunately the enemy had a bit of a setback as well because, well, he couldn't hold on to one of the planets he captured, so we pretty much ended up even. So if we look at the enemy fleet now, as you can see, after our tactical battle, he only has one battleship left. Unfortunately for us, if we look at the broader picture at the galaxy, you can see he still outnumbers us pretty badly. We cut down on his minor ships pretty significantly, but he still has one more battleship than we do. He still has more production than we do, even though our territories are equal. And I'm guessing most of his ships will be concentrated in one of the other fleets. See, this one only has a cruiser and two of each of the small ships. Here we go, this is the big one. This one has two battleships, two cruisers, and five each of the missile and laser ships, so this is going to be a tough cookie to crack. Which means it's probably wise for us to invest a little bit in production right now. We could also spend a little bit of cash improving our planets, but since we don't have a whole lot of income right now, we'd spend all of our income on just improving one of our planets a little tiny bit. So yeah, right now it's probably wiser to just invest in more material. I'm kind of wondering, do I want another battleship? It will kind of damage our available funds pretty significantly, but on the other hand, battleships are awesome, so let's just take one. We got a lot of laser ships last time, so we'll get a few of those this time, but we'll get mostly missile ships just to even it out a little bit. Actually, let's do it like this. There we go. So next turn we'll end up with a bunch more small ships, and in a couple turns we'll have an extra battleship as well. We actually moved back into our system, so yeah, let's see if we can actually finish off this guy. He'll probably take out a few of our smaller ships, but if we can take out fleet number one, that'll be worth it. In fact, I think I might even be very aggressive and just put my battleships way up front. Thanks to the asteroids, I don't think he has much of a chance of just completely taking out my battleship in one turn. But if I'm lucky, he'll destroy the asteroids and I'll be able to fire through them and take him out instead. Of course, he might just move down, in which case I don't get to fire on him at all. And that's actually quite probable that's what he's going to do, but we'll see what happens. We stay in place, and we get to take him out with no problem at all. There we go. Enemy fleet destroyed is most likely what this says. I don't know if it's worth wasting an entire turn on taking out a single battleship, but anytime you can just destroy an entire fleet, I think that's probably a good idea. And we move up to the next year. So now we have 9 more little ships to play with, which means we can probably take out a bunch of the smaller ships. You know what? I think this is the colony report, I'm not sure. Yep, it is. This sometimes happens when you own a planet and it rebels. There's always a chance that it'll come back as sort of half yours, which means, I think it's called a colony. Oh, it's called a union in their case. Yeah, see, the red ones or the blue ones are occupied territory, and these half-covered ones are, in this case, it's called a union. I think on our side it's called a colony, I'm not sure. So that means you get some of the income, and honestly, I'm not sure, maybe a few other advantages. The tricky bit is that I can't really read Japanese, so a lot of this stuff is not entirely clear to me either. So what next? I think we'll make another attempt at conquering that planet on the left there, because it should be fairly easy. Or maybe I'll take the one in the middle, you know what? It doesn't matter. We'll make make a new fleet right over here, the missile ship, and we'll move it. You know what? How tough is this one? This one's actually pretty weak. Maybe I should try and conquer this one. I mean, its defense is 6, so it's not really low, but it might be worth it. But this one has a much larger population and much better development and much lower defense, so yeah, definitely that one first. There we go. Kusho can stay where it is, so we'll be commanded. He's created another fleet. What's this one? Probably means that one of our stats went up or down, I'm not sure. Down by the looks of it. Usually those messages mean stuff like a new factory was built or something was destroyed or something or other. Basically means that you lost or gained a little bit of development on that planet. I used to be able to recognize them all by the characters, but I've forgotten a lot of them in the meantime. In any case, we'll try and conquer this one again. This time I know a little bit more about what's here, so. And I think. Yeah, I think I'll drop the bomb on the second area this time and try and conquer areas 1, 3, and 4. Because 1 and 4 were kind of annoying, but not too terrible. I vaguely remember that area 2 has the really hard ones on the in this planet, but. I'm not really 100% sure, but whatever, we'll see. I know Area 1 and 4 are relatively easy. I mean, the flea guys are annoying, but they're not hard. There's definitely much harder enemies in this game. So I'm trying to take out these first. They should go fairly quickly, and hopefully I'll end up with almost full energy. If I get my bonus thing, yeah. And we'll be able to take these guys out, no problem at all. There we go. And now back to the flea guys. Pick up the spirit. See, already I'm having trouble hitting them. Of course, later on, once you upgrade your weapons, this kind of stuff is going to be a lot easier than it is right now. And of course I'm really out of practice, so as time goes on, hopefully I'll be able to do a lot better. I'm already doing a lot better than the first round. Yeah, see, they take 3 bullets, so that's quite a lot for one of these little guys. Normally these little guys take 1 or 2. That was kind of pathetic. That's okay, we'll just keep trying. So that means I'm going to have to move back to area number 3 when we get to these guys. And hopefully area number 3 will be relatively easy. Ouch. Because we are running out of energy fairly quickly. Jesus Christ. Okay, we're never going to make this. I'm sorry. no, wait, we are going to go the other way. Make sure not to get blown up by turrets this time. Embarrassing to have that happen a second time. I'm already taking way too much time taking these guys out. And getting hit in the process. Jesus. That one a little bit better. That one a little bit worse. Jeez, I'm so close to dying already. I could wait here and conserve my remaining energy and hope and pray that my fleet survives, but when your energy is this low, that's not really going to be an option. And there's no way I'm going to beat these guys, but I can at least give it a try. I mean, they're going to hit me once at least, and I'm probably going to be dead the next time I get hit. So far, so good, though. I guess the stress of being getting almost killed brings out the best in me. Ah, no, go away, go away, go away. I don't want to die, just go off screen. Yep. Okay. Well, I guess we can just set out the clock and hope the bomb takes care of the third area for us. Thankfully, the MSX has a speed-up function, which can fast-forward through this bit. Okay, back to normal. 2, 1, 0. Now, let's see if that was good enough. For us to conquer the planet. Loading, loading, loading. And it was, wow, we actually managed to capture that one. Even though I wasn't expecting to. That's nice, that'll add a fair bit of income, even though, as you can see, we lost a bunch of environment, resources and technology, so our planet product went from either 5 or 6 to 4. So it's not ideal, but hey, at least we got it. Now it might be a good idea to try and fill in these bottom three, so we can consolidate our resources. They're fairly weak, so they should be reasonably easy to conquer. Yeah, but we'll save that for next time. So guys, I think this gives you a pretty good idea what this game is about. There's a few more little tricks and things that you can do, especially planet development. I haven't really shown you yet, or fleet development. You really need a lot more income for that to be worthwhile. So if you have like half the map, then you can really start pumping out stronger fleets and better developed planets, but I think you get a pretty good idea of what the game is about. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. If you have any questions about the game, if you'd like me to showcase anything else, like the extra weapons or that sort of thing, yeah, just leave a comment, and yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.